How else did he try and progress, mold your methods of thinking, the way you looked at the world?
Well, we had a lot of little games. Like he would say at the dinner table, he'd think of some little problem. And he'd say, suppose you were a Martian, we were Martians, and we came down to this Earth and we'd look at it from the outside. And that, I can't explain exactly what he meant, but there's a way of looking something anew, as if you never saw it before, for the first time, and asking questions about it as if you were different. It started with a question of his kind. Suppose you were a Martian who never slept. They didn't have sleep. You didn't have to sleep. And you came down to this Earth and you saw these people had this funny property that every day, for a certain amount of time, had to lie down and become unconscious. And then the natural question would be, how does it feel to get unconscious? What happens to you? Ideas run along and suddenly they stop? Or do they just run more and more slowly? But what happens to your ideas? How does it feel to become unconscious? So I tried to answer the question, what happens when you become unconscious?
But do you find that these days, you still, when you're faced with a particularly difficult problem, when you're absolutely stuck, you tend to say, let's look at it like a Martian would look at it.
Sometimes. There are lots of things that people did. For example, Maxwell put the equations together, the Faraday, he formulated the equations mathematically with some model in his head. And then Dirac got his answer by just writing and guessing an equation. And other people got their answer, like in relativity, got the idea by looking at principles of symmetry. Now, all these methods, and Heisenberg got his quantum mechanics by thinking only talk about the things that you can measure. Now, all of these ideas, we should only talk about things that we can measure. Try to define things in terms of only things you measure. Or let's formulate the equation mathematically. Or let's guess the equation. Or all these things are tried all the time. Look for symmetries. All that stuff is tried. All that stuff, when we're going against the problem, we do all that. That's very useful. But we all know that. That's what we learn in the physics classes, how to do that. But the new problem, where we're stuck because all those methods don't work. If any of those methods would have worked, we would have gone through there. So when we get stuck in a certain place, it's a place where history will not repeat herself. And that's what makes it even more exciting, because whatever we're going to look at the other, the method and the trick and the way it's going to look is going to be very different than anything that we've seen before, because we've used all the methods from before. I don't care. The only thing that the real test in physics is experiment, and history is fundamentally irrelevant.